Bad parenting, one of the biggest problems in this country that people don't really want to discuss. Should single people have the right to criticize bad parenting? Hey guys, it's February 17th, 2017. I'm Reginald, also known as Dimcad. Okay, I did a video recently criticizing people for having children that they could not afford, which seemed logical and reasonable, and most people agreed with me. Here's the deal, some people criticize me for taking on that topic, and it sort of reminded me when I was in college, we were having a similar discussion about the role, about the impact of parenting on society, and I made a point that bad parenting was creating a great deal of problems in our community. And this black lady spoke up right after I was done. She said, well, it's always the ones who don't have kids who always have something to say. They're always the ones who don't have kids who have something to say. And I just thought it was really fascinating. I didn't really engage her, although I was used to really engaging the professors. I wasn't one of those students who just sat around and didn't say anything. I often debated with the other students and the professor. I didn't waste my time with her, but it was an interesting response because I always thought it was completely illogical. Here's what I mean. Just because you're not a parent doesn't mean you don't have the right to criticize a parent, because we're all impacted by the actions of the parents. If a parent does something reckless and creates a situation where a child grows up to become a criminal or a person who engages in violent behavior, it's fair to criticize the parent for not doing what they were supposed to do. It doesn't mean the parent's always at fault, but the fact of the matter is, you are the parent and you are open to criticism, because if you do screw up, there are consequences for everybody. It's sort of like a firefighter who is going around the city setting buildings on fire. Well, I'm not a firefighter, but do I not have the right to criticize a firefighter going around the city setting fires? I'm not a cop, but if a cop shoots an unarmed man who's also in handcuffs and not presenting a threat, then yeah, I have the right to criticize an officer, even though I've never been an officer. What about the doctor who lies to the patient to get an unnecessary surgery or prescribe pills that aren't even necessary? Well, yeah, at some point I do have the right to at least criticize somebody. If a doctor leaves a tool inside of a patient, a surgeon leaves a tool inside of a patient, yeah, that person should be criticized. You don't have to be a doctor to criticize that person. You can, all you need is common sense to recognize that that person is engaging in wrongdoing. So the same standards should apply to parents. No, I don't have to be a bad parent to criticize bad parenting. Fact of the matter is, if someone's a bad parent and they create a child who creates a great deal of trouble and they end up in the criminal justice system and they end up in a number of different areas, doesn't mean that every bad parent necessarily is going to create somebody who's going to end up in a lot of trouble, and doesn't mean that everybody who ends up in the criminal justice system is necessarily a result of a bad parent. But you guys get my point. If they create a child that's unable to take care of themselves, it becomes a man and he's constantly dependent on the government for every little thing, and he's always on some type of program, or they create a daughter who's always on some type of program, and she's having kids that she can't afford to take care of, then the taxpayers are going to have to pay for that burden. If that person ends up in prison, then we're going to have to pay for that burden. We're going to have to pay to incarcerate that person. We're going to have to pay for the court fees and everything else. So parenting, it does have an effect on everybody else. So I think if it affects everybody else, then people have the right to criticize it. I'm talking about on a grand scale. Just common sense things, you know? Maybe it's not a great idea to drive around with your child on your lap. I mean, I don't know. It's just common sense things like that. So I think the logic that lady used was really bizarre and didn't really make any sense at all. I ran into a lot of bizarre characters in college. I wasn't all that normal either. I definitely had my flaws, to say the least. I can do a whole video series on that. But anyway, it's just something I want to take on. It's something I want to touch upon. You don't have to be a bad parent to criticize bad parenting. Speaking of college and universities, it's interesting how so many people just sat in those classes and didn't contribute to the discussion, didn't question the professors on anything. Like, no matter how crazy the professors became, or no matter what they presented as an idea, most people didn't want to challenge them on it. And it's like people are so concerned about just getting that A, that they didn't even care what was even being said in the class. It's sort of an interesting phenomenon. It's one of the reasons why college is becoming less valuable to a lot of employers. You have to have a certain type of degree. I just feel like when you're just sitting there having a discussion on really important things, or you're just agreeing with everything that the professor says or not saying anything, I don't really consider that to even be a real university class. But The times have changed. Anyway, guys, thank you for watching. Thank you for listening. And don't forget, the future belongs to those who prepare for today. Should people without kids criticize people with kids? I don't really talk about individuals, but on a grand scale, yeah. Bad parenting is ruining education. It's ruining a lot of things.